Oh, and that's a good delivery from Cardia. The wrong'un has come back quite sharply. There may have just been a little bit of inside edge there from Hughes. And once again, Cardia has had the better of the Australian captain.
Certainly a wrong'un spinning from off the leg. Got in between a little inside edge, but he beat him completely in flight. And the Australian skipper not picking that delivery out of the back of the hand at all. A fine performance by the leggy. A vital time for Pakistan now. He breaks through with the new ball due, the second new ball, and hits off stump. So it's 321.
And particularly when there's just one over to go to tee, the batsman is going to be thinking of defence. It'll give Cardia the opportunity to attack, and he's doing that with two slips and a bat pad. It's in the air, and Azim has taken the catch. And that move from Zahir has paid off, and it's a very annoyed Greg Chappell getting out right on the tee break, and a very delighted Abdul Cardia.
It's a bit of bounce there for the leggy. It pitched just outside the line of the leg stump. Chappell sweeps in the air, straight down the man's throat, a backward square leg, and Greg Chappell departs for 17.
That was a good catch by Azim when you consider his handicap with his right hand. He's done well to hang on to that one. So that's the sixth Australian wicket down for 404.
So no luck going the way of the leg spinner. Well bowled him, beautiful googly. That was a magnificent ball by Abdul Qadir. Wasn't picked by Lawson. Look back on him and hit the top of leg stump, and it looks as if Kim Hughes, after this dismissal, have a look at that ball. Nipping back, hitting the top of middle of the leg. A beautifully executed googly. And the crowd cheering Greg Chappell off the ground because Kim Hughes has declared the innings closed at 7 down for 509. In the air, and he's got him. Well, that is a rank long hop, and Qadir no doubt very grateful for that wicket, but really it was not a great delivery. Caught pretty well in the end by Zahir, who was stretching away to his right hand side, and that's the end of a magnificent innings by Kepler Vessels. Out, caught by Zahir for 179.
A remarkable delivery that, because it was almost a wide. It almost pitched outside the return crease, spun back slightly, and Vessels must have hit it right at the end of the bat. Put it to the right of Zahir, who extended his arms and had sticky fingers because the ball stuck. So the fourth wicket now has fallen with the total at 353.
Abdul Qadir to Yallop. What a good catch, if it wasn't a bump ball. Well, he's been given out. Yallop is looking at the bottom of the bat, and Abdul Qadir is struck. There was hesitation there. The ball flew to Javed Mian and it slipped.
The first wrong and bowled by Qadir. He bowled an over of leg spinners the previous over, then a wrong one. Yallop went for the drive. The ball turned out of the rough, probably stopped on him a little bit, and Javed Mian at first slip brought off an excellent catch. Possibly Yallop was under the impression it was a bump ball because he hit the ground before the ball struck the bat. So the second wicket has fallen with only 44 runs on the board.
Abdul Qadir to Wayne Phillips. And he's picked him up. The wrong one, the breakthrough. Wayne Phillips trying to turn the ball on the onside there. Has got an outside edge. And the ball has flown straight to the man at slip, Madassa, and it's the third wicket down.
And Wayne Phillips looking to play across the ball. He didn't really pick the wrong one, just caught the edge and presented Madassa with a nice simple catch there. So that's a great breakthrough for Pakistan, perhaps a little bit longer than they wanted, but Australia now 3 for 121.
Oh, that's gone very close to off stump. Kim Hughes obviously didn't realise where the ball was going. Oh, and Kim Hughes attempting to hit that one away on the leg side, missing a full toss.
by hitting across it. Hit right across the line of the ball.
And there's an appeal there from the Pakistan fieldsman. They think it's the wrong one. It's 2 for 108.
That's close, yes indeed. A straight one. And Alan Border is gone. Abdul Qadir claims a wicket. Deception there for the spinner. The one before, he punched through mid-wicket.
Border playing back. The ball pitching just outside the line of off stump there. Angled across, it must have straightened. Our angle's a little bit deceptive here. Border obviously of the opinion that ball would have missed leg stump. Not so umpire O'Connell. And Border is on his way. Playing back instead of four. 4 for 343.
Oh, what a catch. He put one down earlier that was much easier. That slip position. A magnificent catch taken there. That slip this time by... Just need to get a look at the fielder. Salim Malik, the man there, was put in a slip after Zahir dropped that one earlier. And a great catch, and Greg Chappell's gone. Abdul Qadir takes his second wicket, 5 for 354. Marsh facing Abdul Qadir. Well caught. If it's a catch, yes it is. That's well bowled and well caught. Three wickets to Abdul Qadir.
In a very short space of time, as that ball tips the inside edge onto the pad, the helmeted Mudassar at short leg goes down low to take a very good catch. Qadir claims his third victim, Marsh without scoring.
Abdul Qadir comes in now to Jeff Lawson. And that's well bowled. He's got the right-hander and he's picked him up. Man in at short point, Mudassar Nazar. Abdul Qadir takes his fourth wicket. And it's a case of what might have been for the Pakistan team. Twice yesterday and today they haven't broken through for hours. And then suddenly they get the breakthrough and Abdul Qadir is there to wrap up, as he's done there.
Well, Jeff Lawson sat there for days wanting to get a hand. He's got one. He's been caught at silly point. And he departs with daddles. Australia now 8 for 540.
Australia might as well try and stretch this lead as quickly as possible now. And a good wrong in there from Qadir. And John Maguire is out, having got the inside edge through to Wasim Bari. It's a good catch. Never easy when you get the inside edge. That was a good wrong in from Qadir to give him his fifth wicket.
Maguire making the mistake of leaving a gap between bat and pad. The ball clipping the inside edge, probably the pad as well, and into the safe hands of Wasim Bari. And Bari O'Connell raises his finger to send Maguire on his way. Yes, there was a deflection there from bat to pad into the gloves of Bari. Now, it was a pretty good catch, that, because it hit two things, bat and pad. And that meant that Bari had twice to adjust the position of his gloves to bring off the...
He's certainly going to cause these batsmen some problems. Oh, he's bowling! That's it! It's over! Well, Keith Stackpole picked it. Decided to go back and hit it off the back foot to extra cover. Didn't pick the googly. And that's the first breakthrough for Pakistan.
And he really was struggling, Gabriel. He didn't know which way Qadir was going. It was the one that pitched and went just straight on. Came back just a fraction. Got the bottom edge onto the stumps. And what a beautiful piece of bowling that was by Qadir. And a very good decision by Imran to bring him in at this stage of the game. And the West Indies lose their first wicket with 47 runs on.
Haynes faces Abdul Qadir.
Haynes slices it up into the air. And Mudassar gets back to take the catch. So success there for Qadir at last, as Desmond Haynes top edges that attempted sweep shot.
Haynes a little bit out of touch after having been kept from the strike for so long. Going for the sweep, hitting against the spin, the ball bouncing top edge. Mudassa taking a not too difficult catch. Although it might have gone into the lights and perhaps he might have been blinding you, but 2 for 109.
Just working for singles. Not prepared to take too many risks against him. Straight down his throat. He's caught it.
Well, what a terrible ball. And a shot where Richards must have licked his lips and thrashed at it and hit it straight down the throat of the man at deep fine leg, Rashid Khan. Would you believe it?
And the pressure was on Kadir. And when he let that delivery go out the fingers, it stuck there. It was a shocking delivery. One going down leg side, and Richards pinned the ears back and hit it straight to Rashid. And a good catch taken just overhead. And what a magnificent breakthrough for Pakistan. Richards out for two. Caught Rashid Bol Kadir in the West Indies. 320, still needing 65 for a win. Safra. Richardson's taking strike now to Kadir.
Oh, and beautifully bowled and well stumped by Wasim Bari. Richie Richardson goes, and now West Indies are in trouble. The last ball of Abdulkadir's spell. He can't bowl anymore, but he's done the damage out there now.
And what a way, Richie, to finish off his 10th over with a wicket. Beautifully taken by Wasim Bari. It came in between bat and pad, a little more flight, and he beat Richardson all ends up. And Kadir finishing his 10-over spell. One maiden, 3 for 27. And West Indies now 5 for 141, still need 44 for victory. Lots of ones out there. Vessels on strike, Kadir.
Down the wicket, and it's... Oh, what a catch! That's a magnificent catch by Imran Khan. That ball was hit very firmly. Imran Khan didn't really get that far off the ground, but it stuck.
That was great judgment by the Pakistan captain at mid-off, and that was hit with great power by Kepler Vessels. He was looking to hit the ball over the infield, and Imran getting up off the ground, it would have been difficult to judge because he is looking into the vast outer crowd and it's not easy to pick them up down there. And that's the end of a very good innings by Kepler Vessels, but that's the breakthrough that Pakistan wanted in the 36th over. Australia now 4 for 138. This time batting down the order. He's just taken guard and he's replaced Kepler Vessels. He's going to have to face Abdulkadir. The Pakistanis have decided that Abdulkadir is going to bowl the last ones and last overs. Inside edge and the ball bobbing down by the stumps there. No, he's gone. It's gone. It's dislodged the leg stump bail. A drive attempted there by Smith and the ball bobbing back onto the stumps. And so he's out bowled by Kadir. And I think that was the wrong one, Tony, that Smith didn't pick. He was a little unlucky. He drove the ball onto his foot and it rebounded back onto the stumps, and that's an ounce of luck for Pakistan and for Abdulkadir. So certainly paying dividends, bringing Kadir on at this stage of the game and Smith out without scoring. And suddenly a slump by Australia. 5 for 140 in this 38th over.
There's a chance. David Hooks has gone well and truly stumped, and that's a vital wicket for Pakistan.
Oh my word, this was a surrender. It was an enormous surrender. Hooks had made up his mind before Kadir let the ball go. He advanced, he charged the ball wide of the off stump as Kadir saw him coming, put it wider. Hooks missed it by a mile, was out by a mile, and so the last hope of Australia really escalating their total gone now, as Hooks finds himself astray and far from home as Barry whips the bails off. 7 now for 178.
Rodney the Hogg, the man at the crease, and he's not there for long. Very quickly caught and bowled by Kadir, and Kadir gets his 5th wicket of the innings.
And a remarkable performance from the little leg spinner in a one-day game.
5 for 33, his figure. He's on a hat-trick as Hogg pushed forward defensively, pushed too hard. And Kadir, following through, catches it elatedly, does a tumble, a back roll. And Hogg does a backward walk to the pavilion, accompanied by Daddles. Out first ball.
That brings a great deal of joy to any old leg spinner sitting in a commentary box, I can tell you. It's a beautiful piece of deception. Abdul Qadir, he's pitched it round about middle and leg and drawn Greg Ritchie down with beautiful flight.
And well taken too by Ashraf Ali, getting the gloves, and that one spun quite appreciably, and he whipped the bales off in delight. And that was a very good delivery, a lot of spin in that ball. Ritchie once again out in the 30s for 31, Australia 2 for 85.
Bold, beautiful Bosie. Well, there's a turning pitch out there, and Imran Khan has put his faith in Abdul Qadir. The wicketkeeper's not picking which way they're spinning, and neither is the batsman.
And I can remember Qadir wrapping up Kim Hughes in similar fashion in the first test in Perth. And that was a beautiful delivery. Not only the fact that it turned back, but it beat him in flight. And suddenly, Pakistan, they're back into this game with the fall of two quick wickets, and Australia now 3 for 97.
Gone, beautifully bowled and well stumped. The leg spinner with a bit of fight. Rawson coming down to him, and Ashraf does the rest. Fine piece of leg spin bowling.
Yes, certainly got him absolutely stranded. The ball spinning past the bat there. Nicely taken too by Ashraf. The bail off, and Jeff Lawson stranded a couple of yards down the pitch there. So Lawson out stumped by Ashraf off the bowling of Qadir. That's his third wicket for only two. And Australia 8 for 234.
Qadir to Gabriel.
Well, it's a good delivery, well bowled, Qadir. The wrong one, and Richard Gabriel didn't see that one at all. Getting back in a position to cut the leg break, but a leg break it wasn't.
As Richard Gabriel found out to his cost, there are a lot of people who can't pick Qadir's wrong one, and that was an absolutely beautiful ball, coming back a matter of a foot. As Gabriel tried to make room for himself to cut the ball, paid the penalty, was bowled out for 10. And the third wicket is down for 52.
Larry Gomes, the left-hander, facing Qadir.
Oh, well bowled. Beautiful bowling. He didn't read that at all. And very unlucky there not to have picked up that wicket. Bias signalled, and the West Indies 3 for 57.
Abdul Qadir bowls now to Richards.
Well bowled, that's in the air, it's good to be out, he's got him, he's gone!
Up go the hands of the Pakistanis, Viv Richards succumbing to the pressure there. Great captaincy by Javed Miandad, magnificent bowling by Qadir, and no mistake in the catch.
And full credit both to Qadir and to Javed. Javed prepared to take the gamble and beautifully bowled by the leg spinner. And Viv Richards, the great Viv Richards, falling for the trap. Tried to smash Javed out of that position, hit it in the air, went straight down the fieldsman's throat, down at deep mid-off, and a beautiful piece of work by the Pakistanis. And they're right in this game now, so Viv Richards out for 18, caught Mansoor down at deep mid-off, off the bowling of Qadir, and a beautiful piece of bowling, plus a great piece of captaincy.
Well, what a beautiful piece of bowling. Reminiscent of the other evening when Ritchie and Lawson fell to him. What a spell of leg spin.
And Lawson, though, it took a year to get the bales off, and it was a beautiful delivery. Dujon used his feet. He was beaten by fight and spin. And Wasenbury, it seemed ages. Wrongen, he was down. See, Wasenbury fumbles, gathers again, makes the stumping. Umpire Dick French says that's out, and it's a great spell of bowling from Qadir. What a magician with the leg spin he has been against the West Indian side. And the West Indies are now 6 for 75. What a change has come over this match. Got him. Yes. Come down the wicket, push through the top spinner. Abdulkader breaks through. Gordon Greenidge, clean bowl for 70. Fine piece of bowling.
As Abdul Qadir, he's slowed the flow of runs. Greenidge trying to make some innovation there. Peak not exactly in the right position. And the leg spinner has struck. First blood at long last for Pakistan. Greenidge out for 70 in the 26th over. The West Indies 1 for 169.
That brings Vivian Richards to the crease to play his 150th limited over international match. Tries to squeeze out. He's got him to hit across the line. A big appeal by Qadir and he's plumb in front. LBW for one.
Well, Abdul Qadir, fresh from the flight from Singapore, and tremendous loop again, strikes for the second time. Looked as though it pitched pretty much in line. Tony Crafter, the umpire, had no hesitation in pointing to the heavens. And the captain of the West Indies side, Viv Richards, out for only one. The West Indies 3 for 181.
This is going to be Qadir's last over. Oh, and that's a good ball. It's bowled him. A beautiful googly. Not picked by Craig McDermott. And he's got him without any trouble at all.
This is going to really be an interesting replay to see how Craig McDermott here was completely and utterly confused by this googly.
Abdul doing nicely with the wrong in there. Off Craig's legs, back into his off stump. But a very good innings. Just on the same note by Craig McDermott, it was just what the captain needed. A few of us didn't agree with it at the time, but he did well.